every day somewhere or other I am sitting. Maybe different batch, different city, that's all. But my routine is this only. Understand? For the alchemy to happen, both of us have to sit. If only you need to sit, I can go and rest. If only I need to sit, you can go and rest. But unfortunately, both of us have to sit. So, please be seated. No other way. And if at all you feel like grumbling or grudging, just remember only one thing. For you, this is only once in lifetime. For me, this is lifetime. I am continuously sitting. Just remember that one thing. You will be able to sit. Sit with inspiration. Understand one more thing. This is more or less like a journey. This whole program is more or less like a journey. Removing the unnecessary things and throwing out, adding necessary things, and seeing that amrita, immortality, the nectar happen. That is what is the whole process. So please bear the process, bear the whole program, be inspired and go with intensity. Be here with full intensity and inspiration. You will see the experience happening in you. Every click. Understand one more thing. If you just read from my books or see the YouTube clippings, you will have understanding and inspiration. But you have to start executing it. You have to start living those words. But if the click happens in my presence directly, don't even bother about living those truths. The truths will live through you. They will become so powerful inside your inner space. They will just tell you, when they enter your home only, they will be very polite. The moment they enter, they will just say, get out. They will ask you to get out. You don't have to worry, how can I live these great truths? No, they will just live through you. Initiation is so powerful. Whenever the initiation happens from the living being, understand, you don't have to live them, they will live through you. You just know, you are living. Whenever needed, they will just come up. They will just come up and start living through you. So all you need for the initiation to happen, just be alive and available. You don't have to be in the state of able or unable. Just be available, that's enough. Always tell you, just be stable and available, that's enough. You don't have to worry about whether will I be able to or unable. No. Able or unable, just be available. That's all you need for initiation. Only with the inspiration and understanding you have to start worrying about whether will I be able to. Here, you don't have to bother about able or unable. Just be available. I was introducing a concept to you. Samskaras. Engraved memories. I can say all, whatever you think as problem in your life, the root cause is samskaras, even your unexpected accidents. Understand? Even your unexpected accidents. There is no such thing as accident in your life. Everything is clearly your very programming. Please understand. It may be a little unacceptable as far as the things which can be understood by your logic. But don't bother. Relax. You will see in experience when we go through step by step the whole program, the engraved memories which you create inside your system is responsible for everything, your physical illness, mental illness, or accidents, relationships. Relationships are like everyday accidents. See, accidents are like happening once in a while. Marriage is like everyday accident. You will listen a lot of marriage stories these 4 days because that's my favorite subject. See, whenever you escape from some great danger, you always enjoy about it. You always talk about it. There was supposed to be some accident. Unfortunately, you are saved. What do? You will constantly talking about it. And feeling blessed. So, you will listen a lot of stories. We are going to work on removing these engraved memories in the physical plane. Understand? You are being as a 7th level. Physical plane is the body which you are carrying in the as a flesh and blood. This body, you store some engraved memories in this body, physical body, usually the chronic fatigue. Anything you try to do, your mind, your body will say, no, let me rest. You're just waiting to rest. The moment you get chance, you will stretch your leg. Chronic fatigue is the engram you carry in the physical body. Next is your breathing layer. Breathing does not mean just inhaling and exhaling. There are 5 pranas, pancha pranas. You don't have to remember all these words, just remember the idea. Pancha prana, inhaling, staying, spreading. See that when the air goes inside, inhaling is one activity. Then the air stays inside your body and it spreads all over the body. And exhaling and cleaning. Prana, apana, vyana, udana, samana. We have 5 words. For air flowing inside. Air flow is the wrong word, but no other way. Maybe we can use the word prana flow. Inhaling, staying, and spreading all over the body, and exhaling, and clean. Apana, clean. This 5 prana is the 2nd layer. Understand? Even in the pranic layer, you do store engrams. Samskaras. That is why, please don't say. If you understand whatever I am saying, that is more than enough. I will give you time, especially for taking notes. Now, if you start taking notes, the problem is you will stop listening. And usually, these notes you don't even look back 2nd time. I have seen. See, many things which I am saying will be shocking to you. Please understand, in this, my last 5 years, now 5 years, just day before yesterday we completed, 5 years of my public life. In my 5 years of my public life, around 2 million people, students, I have directly touched. With that experience, I tell you, not even 1% of the students have revised the notes which they took from my classes. I am just telling you the fact. It will be lying in one corner in your library or in some old rack. When you shift the house, if you shift the house at all, that time you will take it out, it will be full of dust, you will dust it. Oh, in those days I went to the Vidyan Swami's program, I'll put it in dustbin. Why are you taking notes for the sake of dustbin? Relax. Internalize, that's enough. Maybe in the gap time you can sit and take notes. The 2nd layer is pranic layer, prana flow. You store engrams in the prana flow, desires. That is why whenever you are caught in strong emotions like sex or deep desires, your breathing will change, your breathing pattern will change. Because those engrams, when they get activated, the breathing pattern changes. Every desire has its own breathing pattern. Its own breathing pattern. Third layer is the inner chattering. First layer is physical body. Second layer is the breathing layer. Third is your inner chattering. Inner chattering means whether you are driving or washing or cleaning or eating or cooking or sitting or watching TV, whatever you may be doing, there is a 24-hour FM going on inside. 24-hour FM going on inside. Talking, 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 talking. You don't know what is going on. Understand? Understand an important danger. You are nothing but the totality of your thoughts. Am I right? Unfortunately, you don't even know what you are thinking continuously 24 hours. Then how will you know about your life? People come and ask me, Swamiji, can you predict my future? I tell them, I only change futures, not predict. If I have to predict your future, what kind of a life you are living? What ugly kind of life you are living? People come with a small paper to do this matchmaking. This marriage ceremony, the matchmaking, they come and tell you, they give the paper. Swamiji, just see this, whether the male or female, this guys can marry. I tell them, oh God, if such a big decision can be taken with these two small papers, your whole future is nothing more than these two small papers. We live in such an unconscious state. That is why you are afraid of future. That is why you are afraid of future. 24 hours you don't know what is going on inside you. That is why whenever things happen in your life which you really wanted always, you think it is an accident. Because you were not even aware what you wanted. You work for, you see, you invite somebody through phone, email, fax, telegram, and then send somebody and bring that guy. The moment he enters your house, you say, no, not this guy, I wanted another person. Because you don't know whom you invited. Diseases are very good people. They don't go unless you force them to come to you. Because they have too much limitation. They are too busy guys. Busy people are happy people. They don't go. You invite, send email, text message, SMS, cell phone, and finally you send somebody and bring him. And you say, no, I did not invite him. I did not think he will be coming. I thought somebody else will be coming. No. All your accidents are expected, invited. Understand? In the whole life, there is no such thing as accident or miracle. Your inner chattering, you are not aware of your inner chattering, you are not aware of what you are igniting. If you enjoy what you invited unconsciously, you call that as miracle. If you resist what you invited unconsciously, you call that as accident, that's all. There is no miracle, there is no accident in the life. Everything is clearly invited by you. The third layer, mental layer, inner chattering, is only inviting continuously. You store engrams, there are also samskaras there too. And fourth layer is emotional layer. We call it sukshma sarira, intense emotions. That's the fourth layer. Fifth layer is the layer you experience during deep sleep. The peace you experience during deep sleep. Sixth layer is excitement and joy you experience for no reason, sometimes rarely you will experience, this is what we call Anna Sharira, cosmic body. Rarely, when you really you are in love, when you are really sharing for no reason, not for the reason, not for the sake of some pleasure which you will gain from the other person, no, just for no reason, that time you experience that. Sixth layer, very rare. Seventh layer is enlightenment, which at least none of you experience. The seven layers, let me repeat. First layer is physical layer. Physical body you are carrying. Second layer is breathing layer. Third layer is inner chatter. One is subtler than the other. Subtle, subtler, subtlest. Fourth layer is intense emotions. Fifth layer is deep sleep layer, which you experience, the deep sleep. Sixth layer is the peace or the joy you experience. Seventh layer is enlightenment. In all first six layers you carry engrams, samskaras. All we are going to do is work on those engrams and remove them. It's literally like an operation. Instead of keeping pacemaker, I keep peacemaker inside, that's all. It's literally a surgery. No pacemaker, just peacemaker.